Hi, this is Mato. Welcome to my online chess lecture. In this video, I will show you a game between Wesley So and Sergei Karjakin. This game was played in Norway in 2017. Wesley So had white pieces and he started with e4. Sergei Karjakin played e5, knight to f3, knight to c6, bishop to c4, the Italian game. Bishop to c5, Wesley So castle kingside, knight to f6, d3, and Karjakin castled kingside too. a4, a6, c3, d6, standard move in the Italian game, rook to e1, bishop to a7, h3, knight to e7, white move, d4 was played. How about bishop to g5? Bishop to g5 is not as good as it looks. After knight to g6, knight to h4, knight takes knight, bishop takes knight, h6, knight to d2, bishop to e6. That is how a game Kosansky-Navinsek went in 2003, and black even won, but probably not because of the opening. Back to our game. d4 by Wesley So. Knight to g6, knight from b to d2, c6, bishop to f1, rook to e8, d takes on e5, d takes on e5, queen to c2, black to move, b5, probably not the best move. You will see shortly why. What else can black play? Well, queen to c7 is possible. Bishop to e6 is sensible. And there was a tricky one. Bishop to g4. This is a very interesting move. And if h takes on g4, knight takes on g4, and after rook to e2, knight to f4 with the attack. But probably, after bishop to g4, Wesley So would continue with b4. Okay, back to our game. b5 was played. b4, bishop to e6, knight to b3, queen to e7, bishop to d2, h6, c4, rook from a to c8, c5. Gaining the space on the board and shutting the bishop on a7, white is better. Bishop to b8, looking for a new job opportunity. A takes on b5, a takes on b5, rook to a6, rook from e to d8, knight to a5, queen to e8, bishop to c3, knight to h7, g3, knight from h to f8, rook to b6, king to h7. White to move. What would you do in this position if you had white pieces? Perhaps bringing the rook to the a-file comes to mind. Perhaps. What else? There was a little surprise. And this is the surprise. Rook takes bishop. Rook takes rook. Knight takes on e5. Knight takes knight. Bishop takes on e5. Rook to a8. Bishop to d6. Wesley So sacrificed the exchange for a bishop and a pawn to get to this position. Position is closed, and black rooks are not very powerful, are they? Additionally, white has threats on both sides of the board. On the king side, Wesley So plans to advance the pawns, e-pawn and f-pawn. White is better. The game continued. Rook to a6, defending the pawn on c6, f4, rook from d to a8, f5, bishop to c4, bishop takes on c4, b takes on c4, and now e5, knight to d7, queen takes on c4, knight to f6, e6, if pawn takes knight, queen takes rook. So let's go back a few moves. In this position, probably the most precise move is king to f1 or king to f2, preventing knight to f6. Back to our game. After knight to d7, we have queen takes on c4, knight to f6, e6, knight to d5, queen to e4, f6, e7. Rook to a1 would be a better move. We'll see shortly why. Wesley Saw played e7, and now knight takes on b4, queen takes on b4, rook takes on a5. Kayakin managed to free his game a little bit, but Black Queen is not enjoying her duty, stopping the pawn on e7. Queens are not supposed to babysit pawns, but to have unobligated duties, like checkmating opponent's kings. The game continued. Queen to g4, king to g8, queen to g6, rook to a2, g4, rook to c2, king to f1, rook to b2. Well, rook from a to a2 is not possible, is it? Rook to b2, h4, rook to b4, h5, rook to b2, bishop to c7, rook to d2, bishop to f4, rook to d4, bishop to d6, rook to b4, rook to e2, rook to b1 check, king to f2, rook to b3, bishop to c7, rook to d3, bishop to f4, rook to d4, bishop to d6, rook to b4, king to g3, rook to b3, check, king to h4, rook from b to a3, rook to b1 would be probably a better move, threatening rook to h1, rook from b to a3, rook to e6, rook from 3 to a7, and now rook to e3. Rook takes on f6 is very tempting. And Karjakin didn't play that move. Let's see what happens if rook takes on f6. One line goes like this. Rook takes on e7, rook to e6, rook takes rook, pawn takes rook, queen takes on g6, h takes on g6, rook to a3, g5, rook to e3, e7, h5, king takes on h5, rook to e4, draw. Okay, back to our game. Rook to e3 was played. Rook to a4, king to g3, rook to b4, bishop to c7, rook to d4, bishop to f4, rook to d7, bishop to d6, rook to b7. White to move. What would you do in this position if you had white pieces? Wesley Saw found a way to make a progress. And the move is g5. H takes on g5. h6, threatening queen takes on g7, checkmate. Queen takes queen. Pawn takes queen. Rook to e8. If g takes on h6, pawn is pushed and promoted to queen. Rook takes queen. Rook takes rook. Check. King to g7. Rook to c8. And white is better. Back to our game. Rook to e8. h7 check. King to h8. King to g4. Who is winning? Position is lost for black. Definitely. Maybe white king may even go to f7 to attack black rook. Black to move. What is the best move for black? Is there hope? Sergei Karjakin played f5 check. This move looks like that black just wants to prolong the game for a few moves. But this move is very important. You will see shortly why. King takes on g5. How about king takes on f5? One line goes like this. g4, king to e6, g3, king to f7, g2, rook to e1, rook from e takes on e7, check, bishop takes on e7, pawn is pushed and promoted to queen, rook takes queen, rook takes on e7, check, king takes rook. Black to move. What is the best move for black in this position? It's a stalemate. Back to our game. After f5 check, we have king takes on g5, rook to b1, rook to a3, rook to g1 check, king takes pawn on f5, rook to e1, rook to a2. This is the critical moment of the game. Black to move and to save the game. What would you do in this position if you had black pieces? The move is rook takes on e7. This is an incredible move. Bishop takes rook. Why did Karjakin sacrifice the rook? Can you see the follow-up? The follow-up is rook to e5 check. If king doesn't take the rook, then rook to e4 check, king to g3, rook to e3, king to g2, rook to e2 check. And what now? Rook takes rook. Stalemate. Back to our game. After rook to e5 check, Wesley saw, captured the rook. Black to move. What is the best move for black in this position? Well, it's a stalemate. Congratulations to both players, but even more to Karjakin, who managed to save the lost game. What do you think of this game? And that is all. I hope that you enjoyed watching this video. I wish you good luck with your chess, and bye for now.